Question I was going to ask was if there was any artists or artist collectives that are living and working in Scotland at the moment that excite you, or perhaps in some way hold the essence or elements of what you were doing in the 60s and 70s in Edinburgh and in Scotland.
I'd like to answer the convincing yes, but sadly, I have to answer with a convincing no. I still have hopes that such a reality will come into being. That is, a group of people, maybe I could think of certain very young people that I have been teaching of late, and they are still at school, but that doesn't mean that they're not artists, because I was once asked a very leading question by an 8-year-old child. "Please, sir," he said, raising his hand, "how old do you have to be to become an artist?" And my answer had to be, from the moment you are born, you are an artist. And you have to be that for the rest of your life. You don't want to be the alternative to being an artist, that is, a creative person. You don't want to end up being defined as a plonker. That means you're probably earning your living as a politician or a banker or someone who's a bureaucrat, someone who's playing a very safe game in life and doesn't really use the creative energy that's in every human being. So I hope, I have high hopes that I will find something. At the moment, the art world is such that it encourages people to do very silly things. And that is to use the language of art to become famous and rich and a celebrity. If that's what you want to do, you're never going to be a creative person. You're a creative person simply because you have to make sense of the mystery of being you. And perhaps the only way you can do it is to sing a song, or dance a dance, or write a poem, or do something that surprises you, and which is all about your preparedness to deal with the business of growing old. Because part of the business of being alive is that the process of growing old might cause you to forget who you really are, who you were at the very beginning of your life. And if you go right far back to the moment when you were defined as a child, you're probably finding your true self as someone who was creative to the nth degree. All children have that. If you look at them just for 2 minutes, you will see they sing, they dance, they jump, they make everything into a game. Unfortunately, adults tend to prefer being spectators. Or if they play a game, it's called a war game. And they probably have to have the use of some kind of weapon. The artist doesn't need anything except their capacity to move and to sing and to speak and to reflect on the mystery of each day that passes.
Thank you. That was a great little jingle for the
end. Yeah, right at the end, it was perfect.
And the thing, that was very lovely.
Yeah, thank you so much. Very insightful and interesting and thought-provoking.
Mm.
Yeah.
I wish I could say that the art schools make not the stuffing up of you. The university is also not the stuffing up of you.
Mm.
They present you with useless pieces of paper which say that you've got. An art school actually tends to offer you something which makes you think you're a master of fine art, MFA.
Mm.
Master of fine art. How dare they suggest that? No one is a master. Most people end up as being the very opposite. If that's what they think.
Mm.
You go somewhere and you end up with a degree called the Master of Fine Art. And what is fine art? Is it related to the shepherd controlling a flock of sheep? Is it related to, a doctor, a surgeon operating on the human eye or brain? Is it to do with someone trying to make sense of being a prison officer in the horror story of what we now call a prison? They're there, these things called prisons. And we haven't yet found a way of using creative energy to deal with the problem.
Mm.
When people are inside, they can be guaranteed that they're non-creative.
Mm.
Except in the use of violence, in frustration.
Mm.
Think about all these things. Mm. Think about that when you're thinking of a boot festival. But anyway, I'm rejoicing in the fact I'm here in Wigton, the last place on earth where I thought I would have imagined a book festival to happen.
And what's your experience of the Wigton Book Festival?
Well, unfortunately, I've not been here over the last two. I've been to two before that. But I need it. I would say I need what the Wigton Book Festival represents. It's a kind of little oasis of sanity. And it's in the right, on the right, it's in the right direction, under the right sky, surrounded by the right kind of landscape and seascape. It's the Wigton Book Festival.
Mm.